2012, the Price is Right welcomed our first male model, Rob Wilson.
Grabbing the attention of millions, Rob's modeling and acting career skyrocketed. So we're scouring the country for our next male model. And for the first time ever, we've launched a nationwide search to find him. Ultimately, America will decide who becomes our next male model. Taking on the challenge will be the Price is Right executive producer, Mike Richards, joined by former Miss USA and talent coach Shayna Mokler. And with them today are the Young and the Restless stars Melissa Ordway and Daniel Goddard. Melissa and Daniel will work with the top five on their biggest challenge yet, a cold read of a soap scene. Can they wow the judges one last time? Who will make the final three?
Welcome. My name is Daniel Goddard. I play a character called Kane on The Young and the Restless.
And I am Melissa Ordway. I play Abby Newman on Young and the Restless. And Daniel and I have gotten to come over to The Price is Right several times and get to model stuff. The CBS daytime is one big happy family, so there's lots of crossovers. Mm-hmm. But you have to know what you're doing.
We'll have some models from Price is Right come over and do guest spots on Y&R. Y&R people come over to Price is Right, so it's a big kind of melting pot. And what we look for are people who can, you know, learn some lines, deliver some stuff, have a good time with it. And that's what this is about. So what we're going to do is we're going to do a scene, and then you guys will be incredibly fortunate to work with this beautiful girl. You're going to read it with Melissa. We'll give you some notes, and then you'll go out, prepare it, come back, and we'll get on tape and we'll see how we go.
You guys ready?
Yes. Yes. All
right. Yeah. All right.
So tell me, how is your ex-cop boyfriend so dumb that he can let a woman like you get away?
Oh, well, we didn't have much in common. He didn't like that I have family money, and I don't mind spending it on a guy.
Did I mention to you I have absolutely no problem with that whatsoever? But listen, seriously, let me take you out tonight. Let me take you out of this jazz club I know and just have fun.
I would love to, but my parents are throwing this benefit, and old me, yeah, she would have brought you, thrust you into the whole family thing.
Okay, but the new you's trying to slow it down, right?
Right.
Okay, all right. Let's get together later then, okay?
All right, I'll call you afterwards.
Tough job, man.
It's a very tough job. Someone's going to do it, and luckily it's me.
I'm really impressed with the challenges that we've been given. Pleasantly surprised every time.
So, Jay, you want to go first? All right, man.
I feel like a kid in a candy store right now. I mean, that was just awesome. Just that chemistry is so important between actors on stage. She's such an easy person to look at and be like, oh. You know, you immediately are connected to her, but she's just so pretty.
How was your boyfriend the cop dumb enough to let a woman like you get away?
Oh, we didn't have much in common. You know, he liked mushrooms on his pizza, and I liked caviar and little pieces of toast.
Nah, see, I'm always willing to expand my palate.
Ah.
Here's what I like. I love the fact that you guys, and this is important to everybody, you make the eye contact. It's hard when someone gives you some sides for the first time. A lot of people get buried in the words. And at the end of the day, the words aren't the most important thing. It's about connecting with the person.
But how about we leave here and catch some jazz at this little club I know? Let me treat you to that.
Attack the start of the scene. It's like if you start a 100-meter dash, if you start slow, it doesn't matter how fast you run at the end, everyone's gonna be gone. You know what I mean? Find that way to start the scene at the beginning with the energy.
I see. I'm always willing to expand my palate.
Oh, sorry, that was my fault.
That's all right.
When Mel dropped the line, mm-hmm. you guys had a real moment that happened where she laughed, you laughed, and you saw the scene went from like two people delivering information to like a real charismatic, spontaneous moment. And that's the sort of stuff that you guys can do. You find those little moments that will make it, like when you walk out, people go, oh, that guy, because he did such and such. It'll stick with everybody.
But how about we leave here and catch some jazz at this little club I know? Let me treat you to that.
Here's my advice for you. When in doubt, if you don't know the words, smile. Because you're talking about, say, for example, on our show or Price is Right, there's a lot of smiling that'll happen because it connects you with the audience.
I clean up pretty good if you just want to, you know, have some arm candy.
Oh, really?
I clean up pretty good if you want, just want some arm candy.
Oh, do you?
I clean up pretty well, but...
Oh, do you?
if you wanted to take me to this event.
There's a part you're holding back. And it's probably because you're not sure of the words.
Mm-hmm.
But don't let not being sure of the words keep you from putting yourself out there.
I'll call you afterwards.
Why don't we just get together after?
Why don't we just get together after?
Sounds good.
I'll call you afterwards.
Cool.
It was kind of a heavy scene. I said that I was not gonna do it if I had to kiss her, fully kiss her.
Why don't we just get together afterwards?
All right, I'll call you after.
I wasn't prepared for that.
Easy.
Fortunately, I wouldn't have done it. It's just out of respect for my wife.
That was one of the coolest things I have ever done. I mean, to be doing a scene with somebody that's on a soap opera, being judged by people that are on a soap opera, and to get feedback from them, and then to tell you exactly how it is done, and what you're doing right, what you're doing wrong. I mean, it's crazy, crazy amazing.
They were good.
They were good. I gotta say, like, the first time for reading a scene, it's tough.
I am excited to see what they do once they have a little bit more time with the material.
Me too. So let's give them some more notes if they need it, bring them back, and do it again. Perfect, okay.
Hi, how are you?
I'm good. All right, so you got to meet with the team, Melissa and Daniel. You rehearsed. Well, wow us. Let's do it. Go ahead.
How was your boyfriend the cop dumb enough to let a woman like you get away?
Well, we didn't have much in common. You know, he likes mushrooms on his pizza, and I like caviar on little pieces of toast.
Now, see, I am always willing to expand my palate.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Well, he didn't like that I had family money, and I don't mind spending it on a guy.
I've got no problem with that. Now that you mention it, I encourage that kind of thing. But how about we leave here and we catch some jazz at this little club that I know. Would you let me treat you to that?
Well, I would, but you know what, I should get going.
Already?
Yeah, I have a busy day tomorrow. It starts early.
Okay, how about tomorrow night?
My family is throwing this benefit, and old me would have invited you and thrust you into the whole family thing, but...
But now you're taking things slow.
Yeah.
I see. Of course, I square up pretty good. If
you do
just want some arm candy for the event?
Well, let me just warn you that the last time I brought a date to a family event, a hired assassin shot my brother and they had to defuse a bomb in the basement.
Huh.
Still interested?
How about we just meet up after?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'll call you afterwards.
It was a good read. I think you guys connected well. But I think within you, there's even more.
I'm like blown away. I gotta be honest.
Yeah.
I'm blown away because I've watched you, you know, do the showcase before. This just felt really good for you and comfortable for you, mm-hmm. you know, and just want to see more of it because it was fun to watch.
I thought you did a great job, and there was like moments in the scene where I could see you like start to smile, and I was like, yes. It was like a flicker of like, just such happiness that I wanted to see more of, but it was amazing, and you are so charming, and it was a great job.
How was your boyfriend the cop dumb enough to let a woman like you get away?
Well, we didn't have much in common. You know, he liked mushrooms on his pizza, and I like caviar and little pieces of toast.
See, I'm always willing to expand my palate.
He didn't like that I have family money, and I don't mind spending it on a guy.
I don't have a problem with that. Now that you mention it, I encourage that sort of thing.
Oh, really?
Yeah. But how about let's leave here, go to this little jazz club I know. Let me treat you to that.
All right, Daniel, you were there, you were the coach. What'd you think?
I like that you learned it so quickly. I was very impressed with that. I think the thing that I was saying before too is that you have like that southern charm. That's what everyone wants to see. So, you know, have that charm carry through everything you do.
I have to say, I thought it was really awesome, and you were really natural, and I believed you. It was a sincere read. You were a little serious. I would like to have seen you play with her a little bit more, you know, in the scene.
It was like more homeland than, you know what I mean? Like, how are you gonna blow up the White House? Not homeland, Price is Right. You know what I mean? Lighten it up, because when you smile, it's great.
Yeah, I think you guys, you're absolutely right. It's a tough job, man. You did a great job.
Thanks, well Jay.
Thank you very much.
How about we get out of here and we go to a little jazz bar I know. Let me treat you to that.
You know what, I would love to, but I have to get going.
Already?
Yeah, I have an early day tomorrow. Lots of stuff to do.
How about tomorrow night?
I would, but my family's throwing this benefit, and old me would have invited you and thrust you into the whole family thing, but...
Now you're taking things a little slower.
Exactly.
I see.
All right, sounds good. I'll call you afterwards.
Okay. So, how long are they going to let this go for?
What'd you think, Coach?
I think that his Australian charm was spilling all over Melissa through the entire scene.
Yeah, I was really pleased. I mean, I do agree with you. The accent and the Australian thing, it just works. I don't know why, but it just does. I think I did it like every time.
You listen to her, you connect with her, you smile with her. I saw you pull her in.
Your eye contact with her was awesome because I really felt like you were in the moment with her, which is really difficult for actors to grasp, to be in that moment. And I really liked how you made it fun and you flirted with her, you know, and that's what it was about.
I thought you did a great job. I loved how you laughed through it. You made it a little bit lighter because that's kind of what Price is Right is. You have to be yourself and you brought a lot of that to it and I liked it. I thought you did a great job.
Thank you.
Thanks, James.
Old me would have invited you and thrust you into the whole family thing, but...
But now you're taking things a little slower, I see. Of course, I do clean up pretty good if you want some arm candy for the event.
Well, the last time I brought a date to a family event, a hired assassin shot my brother and they had to defuse a bomb in the basement.
Why don't we just get together after?
Exactly. Okay. I'll call you afterwards.
Okay.
Oh, he went for the cheek. He's a gentleman. I know.
This is getting really hard. You know, I thought this was going to really trip all these guys up, but you guys are doing a really, really great job. You know, one thing that a lot of new actors do is they focus on the lines a lot. Like, they're like, I got to get this line right, and it's coming up, and she's going to say this, and then I'm going to. So I could see, like, your wheels were turning a little bit in your head, like, okay, she's saying this, and my line is. You know, and I think when you just let that go, and it just comes from experience and being on set, that allows you to be in the scene. And I think when you allow yourself to do that, it's gonna even be better.
And you know what? This is a thing we've talked about with you from the beginning is that, you know, just you're so polished and you're so together. And when you let the joy out, you're amazing. And we've seen it now. So now I know it's there. A great start, serious end.
Okay.
But I mean, overall, I can't believe how well you did that, given that you just got that 10 minutes ago. Thanks, Edgar.
Thank you.
Good job.
Appreciate it, guys. How's your boyfriend, the cop, dumb enough to let a woman like you get away?
He didn't like that I have family money and I don't mind spending it on a guy.
I've got no problem with that. Now that you mention it, I encourage that sort of thing.
Okay. You know what, I should get going.
Already?
Yeah, I have a busy day tomorrow. It starts early.
How about tomorrow night? Now you're taking things slower. I see. Oh, really? Well, why don't we just go together afterwards?
All right, call me after.
Scene's still going.
See, that's the energy that we know is inside you that we want to get out.
And also, I guess for an acting note, and I know this is also very hard, but maybe just listen a little bit more, because I felt like you were kind of like, oh my gosh, my line's coming, and then you were almost like not really in the scene. You were kind of more worried about the lines.
You know, there were moments in that scene where if you had time to really learn the script, it was in your head, you would have had more fun.
Okay. I'm gonna have you do it again. It's not gonna count for the voting. We have our opinion in our notes. But I want you to do it again and never stop smiling and don't worry about what the words are. Mm-hmm. So you know what I mean? Like, I just want you to hit on her. Ready? Big.
How's your boyfriend, the executive producer of The Price is Right, dumb enough to let you get away?
Well, you know, we don't have the same things in common. He likes mushrooms on his pizza, and I like caviar on little pieces of toast.
Well, you don't have a spray tan like me.
Well, I do get spray tans sometimes, but hey, do you like a girl with family money?
My last Any girl boyfriend. With money is a girl for me.
Oh, really? You like the, you like that?
Spray tans and money. Yeah. That's all I care about.
Great. There you go. Oh my God. That was awesome.
Hi.
Hey.
What's up, fellas?
Hey.
Good.
It's a good looking group.
It is a good looking group. First of all, I want to start by thanking all of you for putting in the time and the effort to get this far. I think you know, based on my intensity for this process, this is really serious business to me. The Price is Right's incredibly important to me, to CBS, to a lot of people, and you guys have done a great job collectively, and we really appreciate it. So thank you. Give them a round of applause.
Yay!
Good job, guys. Good job,
guys. Nice. Nice. Here you go. We've got to narrow it down to three. Three of you are going to go on the talk. And then it'll be up to America to decide who they want to be on the show. Jared, our 18-year-old that submitted over the internet on PriceIsRight.com has impressed us at every stage, who I thought would not make it out of the first round, and I've told you that, and now here you are with a spray tan. So congratulations.
You know, Jared, I have seen you just really come out of your shell since the first day we saw you. And I think it takes, you know, a lot to come out here, you know, come to California, put yourself out there, do something, you know, that you've never done before. And I just wanted to give you a lot of props.
You have an enormous fan base here, the staff, the crew, and everyone. Ultimately, I think that this was too soon for you. And great job. Congratulations for making it this far.
I just want to thank all the judges, all the models, everyone who works behind the scenes. Thank you so much for the opportunity. Couldn't have asked for a better experience. Thank you. Even though I'm going to be going home soon, I'm going to go back to Pittsburgh to finish school, but I'm definitely coming back to LA.
All right, so let's go to Jonathan. Jonathan, you know, you're a guy who went out of town in the middle of it. Could have disadvantaged you, but you rose to the occasion, you pulled it off, you were great on The Insider, and what's your take on Jonathan?
I think that Jonathan, from here, whether you end up getting this job or you don't, never take anything negative from it, only take the positive, and with that, move forward.
It has been so much fun watching you sort of evolve, you know, watching you go through the whole process. And you know, what you're saying is right. You know, you're here for a reason, you know, and it's because you just keep getting better and better. And I hope you take that confidence and, you know, and you use it.
I do think you keep getting better and better. And that's why I want to see you on the talk. That's why I want to see America vote for you. And you're in the final three. Congratulations.
Yay!
Good.
James, talk to your man James here.
You are so much fun, and you know, and I don't know if it's just your accent, but you're very comfortable, and that makes it easy for us to relate to you. And you've done that in all the challenges so far. You know, whether you were just modeling stuff or you were showcasing, you know, you had a real ease, and that's what makes people attracted to you.
You know what? I think in this competition, you've been one of our more consistent people, and I feel very comfortable with you being the next male model on our show. I want to see you on the talk. I want to see America vote for you. Congratulations!
So
moving on to the final, buddy.
Perfect.
Our final two. Here we go. We'll start with Jay. Jay, I mean, you're this Southern, I described you as McConaughey-like in your Insider video. Man, what an easy guy to be around. And, you know, I think you've had an up and down road. I think you've had challenges you were great at, and I think you've had challenges that you admit that have been tough.
You know, and I agree with you. You have had some ups and downs, but one thing, you know, that's so great about you, Jay, is when you have to be on, you're on. You know, when the camera comes on, you really light up and shine, and that's a quality that I think is really important for this position.
All right, let's go to Edgar. So, Edgar, I think you've also had ups and downs. You've had great moments, and you've had not as great moments. You've taken some coaching. You've tried to get better at it. I think you're the most buttoned down one. Like, there's not huge fluctuations in the performance. There's better things and worse things. But, like, to me, you're kind of reliable in that way. I go, hey, you're going to be so appropriate down to when you leaned in to kiss Melissa and you kissed her cheek. Like, I was like, and I literally, like, of course. Edgar the gentleman, like, I, you know, like, that's, and I think that's a great compliment.
You know, it's so difficult because, like you said, Mike, you know, the both of you are very similar, and it's tough. It's a tough point in the competition.
We have gone around and around, and again, it's been aggressive, It's been tough, and I'm gonna do something that was not planned, that is not part of the format, because we literally cannot decide. Because Jay was better in the soap scene. Edgar, I thought, did a really good job in the showcases. That's the show. So, and we're literally, I mean, we've got the network people, we've got all the producers and everything, and we are going round and round and around. I'm not trying to prolong this, I swear. I wanna be done as much as you guys do, but I also wanna make a great decision. Here's what I wanna do. I'm gonna give you 5 minutes, each of you, to give me why you should be the next model on The Price is Right. Collect thoughts and tell me, because now, in the most pressure-filled part of a show that's actually supposed to be done now, can you elevate and can you take it home for us? Fair? You got 5 minutes. Good luck, guys. All right, you guys, you have 5 minutes. You ready? I'm gonna have Daniel Goddard flip a coin. Jay, your scene was first. I'll have you call it in the air.
Heads.
It is heads. Heads. What do you wanna do, go first?
I will go second.
You will go second. Edgar, you're up. Jay, take a step back. All right, Edgar, go ahead.
All right. I think the real question is, why shouldn't I be on The Price is Right? I don't live in LA, I'm not single. I'm a family guy. Maybe I've been up and down during the competition. But I think that I actually embody what the whole show is all about. When I watch the show, I see full families on TV, having fun, having a good time. And I think that I represent that. I'm not ashamed that I'm here and the only married one, the only one with a kid. I think that's a strength of mine. I think that's what gives me strength. I'm also adaptable. I know I have my values and I know I have my integrity, but I'm very adaptable. I'm adaptable to the LA scene. I'm adaptable to any scenes that you throw at me. I know I can bring that energy. I know I can rise to the occasion. I have a lot of talents and I have a lot of I have a lot of emotions inside of me that I know I can bring out, that I know that when I'm called, when the bells ring, that I can come up and I can do it. I assure you that. And I just know that just because The Price is Right is all about family, and that's me too, and that's where my strength is from. So that's why I should be on The Price is Right.
Nice job. Really good. Take it away.
First of all, thank you guys so much. I literally have felt like a kid in a candy store today, especially working with you two. And just pointing out why I should be the third person in this competition. Every piece and everything that I've heard, criticism, you name it, I've tried to incorporate it. And I think, like you said, I may turn it off too much when the camera's not on me, but I do feel like when the camera hits that I am consistent, I can do the job, as well as take that criticism and become even better. And like you said, adapt. When I'm put in those positions, pressure, you name it, like I will turn it on. I will be that guy that can be clutch. And I will smile until my cheeks get cramps. And I'll put on one last show for you guys because that's what this show's about. Sorry, gotta break out every little thing I can. So thanks for joining The Price is Right. Be sure to get your pets sprayed or neutered. That's it.
Good job, guys. We'll have you put your shirt back on. I am really glad that we just did that, because getting to hear from you guys, where your heart's at, what your interest level in the show is great. Something in all of that stood out to me. I love that you're talking about your family, and I love that you're a family guy, I'm a family guy. It's important, it is a family show, and I think that's a really good thing. Jay, you have been up and down. You were smiling during that, you were engaging, and I'm just gonna say that you created a moment just now. Talk more about taking control of the situation and creating a moment. And for that reason, we're gonna move you on to the final three. Edgar, thank you. No, that was brutal. And I'll be honest, the whole thing was brutal. And it's a testament to how good you guys are. And Jay, you really did make it easy, because to me, and I say this to the models on The Price is Right, and to Drew and to George, Price is Right is about moments. So Jay, Jonathan, James, congratulations. You are now headed to the talk where you will be announced to America. And that will be about making moments there too and engaging with those great ladies on the talk. They're great at making moments. The question is, can you make one? And then who will America get behind? And that's what we get to find out. So congratulations, good luck, and good luck to America choosing between these three guys, because they're amazing. Congratulations.
Good job.
Tune in to The Price is Right weekdays on CBS.